Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Options Trader Today. So today in this video I'll explain you how Euro USD, USD CAD, USD JPY and USD CHF has moved in the last week and how these forex can move in the next week. See, first of all we'll be looking at Euro USD. What we have seen, there is a continuous downfall, and this downfall you can say is from end of December 2021. Downfall is from end of December of 2021. We have seen a swing forming at this particular level. After that, what we have seen, there is a continuous downfall. Okay, and now what we have seen after that, it has tried to move upside, and a probability is there if this level sustain, we can see it can go further higher. Okay, so before that, what we have seen, a volatile market for Euro USD, because the price of USD being fluctuating for so long. So now suppose if this level sustain, which is a higher probability, we can see it can go further upside and can touch a level of $1.01156. Okay, and if that level goes upside, a probability is high, we can see it can go further upside towards a level of $1.03963. Okay, and if that level goes upside, we can see it can go further higher towards a level of $1.07868. And if that level goes upside, then there is a higher probability, we can see it can go further upside and can touch a level of $1.11834. Okay, and from there we can see it can go further higher. Now if this level didn't sustain, what we can see, if this level didn't sustain, there is a higher probability again that if it can touch a level of $0.98512, and from there we can see it can move further low and can touch a level of around $0.97125. okay, and if that level goes further down, then there is a very high probability we can see it can touch a level of $0.8500 also and can move further higher, because we have not seen this level has come for so long, because this is the only period we have seen. If the price fall below a level of $1.99256, then there is a probability of touching a level of $0.93314, because this is the range where we have seen it has not touched for so long. So probability is high it can go further down if it fall below this particular level. Okay, now we talk about USD CAD. So now we talk about USD CAD. USD CAD is also showing a huge volatile range. Okay, but it is trying to move upside in a ascending order. So suppose if this level goes upside, which is a higher probability because it is moving upside but slowly with a volatile range, so a probability is there we can see a level of $1.31046, and from there we can see it can go further higher towards a level of $1.31000194. okay, and suppose the price range this particular level, which is a higher probability that we can see it can break this particular level, a range of 1.3122, because this is the range which is already being tested here, so probability is high we can see it can touch a level of $1.342012, and from there we can see it can go further upside, because this is the range where we have seen the price of USD CAD has moved for so long. So and it is already being tested, so a resistance is weak, so probability is high we can see it can move further upside. Okay, or once this range breaks downside, okay, once this range breaks downside, we can see it can fall further low towards a level of $1.29708. okay, and if that level goes further down, then we can see a level of $1.2803. okay, and if that level goes further down, then there is a probability of touching around $1.26068. okay, and if that level goes further down, then we can see it can touch a level of $1.25321. okay, because this is the range, once this range breaks, we can see it can move further low and can there be a sharp fall. Okay, now we talk about USD JPY. What we have seen, there is a continuous upside. Okay, why this upside has come, because what we have seen, it has moved upside, but this is after for so long period that there was a probability that it can move further up, because there is a cup pattern forming, plus this range has not come since 2003, so was, and there will be higher probability we can see if this level sustain that it can go further upside towards a level of $145, and if that level sustain, then we can see it can go further high. Okay, but suppose if this level didn't sustain, then we can see it can come down again to a level of $139.516. okay, and if that level also didn't sustain, then we can see it can touch a level of $137.212. okay, and once if it goes below that particular level, then we can see it can go further down towards a level of around $132.807. so you have to keep this in mind that the price fall below this particular level, then we can see it can go further down. Okay, and if it moves upside, above 145, then we can see it can go further upside. Now we talk about USD CHF. Again, it is moving in a particular range, but it is very volatile. Okay, it is trying to make a pattern, what we call say U pattern, opposite U pattern, and this is a handle, but on the opposite side. So if this level breaks downside, a probability is high, we can see it can move further low. But if it goes upside and move above a level of 1.00346, then we can see it can make a new high and can touch make a new high after 2011, then it can cross this particular range. So suppose if this level goes $4, and from there we can see it can touch a level of $0.98767. Okay, and suppose if the price goes up that level, then there is a probability we can see a level of $1.00584. Okay, and if that level goes upside, then we can see it can touch a level of $1.02252. Okay, and suppose the price goes up that level, then we can see it can make a high of around $1.03354, and this particular level is a range high as well as the support, which has already been weak. So probability is high, we can see it can go further upside towards a level of $1.2897, and from there we can see it can go towards a level of $1.06854. We can see it can go further upside. But suppose if this level didn't sustain, which is currently trading at around $0.96072, we can see it can move further low towards a level of $0.9534. Okay, and it can touch a level of $0.9466. Okay, and suppose if the price fall below that level, then we can see it can touch a level of $0.93818. Okay, and from there we can see it can fall further low towards a level of $0.92799. Okay, and if it falls below that particular level, then we can see it can move further low towards a level of $0.91102, and from there we can see it can move further low towards a level of around $0.8999. Okay, and from there we can see it can move further down. Any doubt regarding this, you can mail me. So hope you like the video, and if you like the video, please give a thumbs up, and if you're new to my channel, please subscribe.